that is a lot of excitement for a very, very long weekend. So I'm very impressed with you guys. My name is Jeremy Fedma. I'm the Vice President of Internet Services for Market America. I've been around this company a long time. Got started back in 1999 as an unfranchised owner. Started with the Web Center program when it first launched back in 2000. Was one of the very first Web Center owners. Was able to get into a beta test for this technology, and I've been a part of pretty much every training system that we've ever developed for helping move these products. And I've seen the system from version 1.0 and you doing everything as a Web Center owner to where we are today in version 4.0 and all the systems that we have and everything that we've come out with. So it's been a very, very exciting a road for me, taking it through everything. In 2007, they asked me to come on board and head up this division, which I did. And then a few years ago, I was able to convince somebody else, Sarah Rose Stack, to come on board and help me with this division because it's been growing so phenomenally all over the world. And Sarah's done an incredible job with this. So, thank you. So what this is the Web Center Certification Training 101 class. And I just want to introduce you to the format and then turn it over. So this is what we call an all-star training, which means it's not just one of our trainers or me or Sarah giving this class. It's all of our trainers giving you this training. And as a matter of fact, Sarah just told me about this a few minutes ago. Every one of the people that you're going to see train you here has been a certified Web Center Trainer of the Year, with the exception of one person, because this was their first year training. So it's really good for you guys. I guess with the exception of myself, too. I was never certified Web Center Trainer of the Year. I was going to give it to myself a couple of years. But they said I couldn't do that. I didn't think that was very fair. So with that said, the way the format's going to work is we've broken the entire Web Center Certification training down into segments. And each of our trainers is going to come up and deliver a segment to you and teach it as if you were in their class. And then we'll shift it off to the next trainer and the next trainer. So you're going to get this just incredible sort of rich experience of hearing all of our different trainers sharing their expertise and their information. And it really is a treat. We did this last year, and it was really well received. And like I said, this is a sold-out class, so that's been phenomenal for us as well. So I think this is something that we'll continue to do and grow with. So without any further ado, let me turn it over to our first trainer of the day, which is Russell Polo, and he's going to deliver the first section for us.
Okay, you all hear me? Sounds good. I'm Russell Polo from the Kids in New York, and I was the unsupportive spouse when my wife first brought this business to our household. She said, here, drink this, and I did. And I had very little interest in this business until she found Web Centers and checks started showing up in the mailbox. And if you'd like to have an experience of checks showing up in your mailbox or now direct deposit, I think this is something you want to learn about. We're going to ask if you have cell phones, please keep them quiet. We're, of course, recording this. And the corporate office is allowed to record this. You are not allowed to record this. This is, you know, for their purposes. If you have questions, we want you to write those down. We don't want to have to delay the training a lot. But if there's some terminology that is not being explained, some abbreviation, you want to be sure that that's understood. We don't want to roll ahead and not have to understand some terminology. Most of the questions you have problems will be covered at some point during the training, and if they're not, at the end, we'll make a point to make sure you have a chance to do those answers. The main support website for the entire program is MAWC 411. That is the place you want to go to for all things Web Center. It's been redesigned, responsive. Thank you, Sarah. So there she is. Thank you so much for everything that has gotten to us and is the place you're going to go to find any resources in terms of downloads of this training or the Fast Start Guide, any of the resources you need, you're going to go there. At the end of the course, is there evaluation in this class? Jeremy, are we doing evaluation today?
No.
No.
No, all right, so no evaluations for you. So what to expect today? We're going to learn a simple proven program that lets you meet and speak with small business owners and provide a solution to them that helps them service their customers, make money, simplify their business process, and you make money in the process. That's all there is to it. I did not say in there anywhere that you need to become an IT expert and a web developer. That's the trick. Don't do that. We're going to learn about the market and the product. We're going to cover who it is that can use this and how it can benefit. We're going to talk about setting some goals that you can achieve and determine a way that you can be successful by using the program. We're going to cover some workshops. We're going to work in defining goals and calculating what those goals mean in terms of actions and results. And from that, we're going to develop an action plan to turn into retail and what kind of results you want to produce from web centers when you're working with retailing, who to meet, who to speak to, and so forth. We're going to do a workshop, we're going to define a names list, your first initial contacts, who you're going to reach out to, and we're going to do some live in-person practice for that role so you're able to experience what it's like. And then we're going to go over the details of how your web center is used, the technology of how you schedule an appointment, how you can control people see online, and that's going to be the details there. And finally, we get into business building, how web centers can be used as a stone in the entire foundation of your Mark America business to build a residual ongoing income that pays you on and on. And then we'll have a chance to ask questions at the end of the day. So the first thing I want to talk about is attitude knowledge. If you've been to a basic five training, you'll notice that the first of basic five is very critical that you understand the product, because you can't talk about it if you don't know about it. Now, is anybody out there, first let's talk about the market. So all of you out there, we saw at the convention, we had all those cell phone camera lights illuminating the entire arena, thousands of them. You know, everybody out there's got the cell phones. What are we using those things for? We're looking for things online, getting answers to questions. We no longer wait to go to the library to look up something. We just pull up the cell device and say, what's the answer to this question? Where can I get this service? Where can I buy this? People look at those answers immediately online. Everything is going online. Everything is becoming mobile. And so you think about, where do you do these things? Get your news. Where do you do social media? Where do you search for products? All of this is taking place online, most places even mobile now. Now, I mean, you look at the statistics of what's happening. I don't want to read all these, but the one that really blows me away is this top right, 64 to 72, the group of people that you expect to have the old VCR that still links 12, because you think they're not tech savvy. Even that group, 73% research products online, 91% use the web for email. Even those people, the people you don't think are online, they're online. Everybody's online. So what does a small business owner have to deal with? The social climate, everything is moving online. Everybody is asking questions of their friends online. They're all connected. They're having access to more resources and answers. What's going to happen to the small business owner who doesn't have his content and answers available online? No one will find him. And all of us, of course, will be more mobile, because people want to get the answer right now while they're out. They don't wait until they get home and look it up on the desktop. So what is Web Centers? What is Mark in America? What is it that we're doing? What do we have here? Well, we're a partnership. Because this is a partnership of Mark in America, the Worldwide Corporation, Web Centers, the company that provides the website product. You can think of them just like the manufacturer of OPC. It's a contractor that provides this product for us. And the third component of that partnership is you. You are part of the partnership, you're not out on your own, you have all the support behind you. So you get in the habit of saying we, not I. We have been in business over 15 years. We have tens of thousands of clients, hundreds of employees. We do business in 23 countries globally. Can we all say that? We have tens of thousands of clients. How many clients?
We have tens of thousands of clients.
Awesome. Globally. And so by remembering that context, you immediately have more posture than being the person who's never sold a website, has never had a successful sale, because you are working with a corporation and an organization that has serviced all these people. So it is a proven duplicatable system. By following the steps we're going to go over today, you can go out there and meet small business owners and close the deal. You do not need a whole lot of resources to do that, because resources are already there. They're not something you have to build, something you just have to participate in, follow the steps, do the system. So what do we provide to small business owners? We provide them all these resources. We can help them increase their revenues, decrease their expenses, increase customer satisfaction. But you want to think about how it is we do this? Well, if a small business owner is only able to sell products out of his storefront, if only people who walk by his store or drive by and see his sign outside, that's a small market. He's only able to sell to a small number of customers. But if he's online, anybody anywhere in the world who can find his website becomes his customer. So suddenly he's able to sell to many more people. Decreasing expenses, of course, is the benefit of being able to have a participation in economies of scale. But just imagine the time wasted. If he has to answer the phone to give someone directions to his store, whereas someone could go online, find the address, and come without having to call and waste his time to do that. Better customer satisfaction, because the customer's going to know what to get. When they come in the store, they're going to come in better prepared. They know what he offers. They're not going to come looking for something he doesn't have, because they've already seen his website. They know what he has. It's all about giving them the best results online. Now, I want to talk for a moment about posture. Has anyone here ever recommended a movie to somebody? Yeah. We've all done it. So, what if you went to your friend and said, I think you should check out this movie, it's pretty good. It's a good movie, I like it. Is that really going to inspire you to see that movie? No. But if you say, oh my God, this movie was incredible. I was on the edge of my seat for hours, the whole thing, I couldn't believe. In the end, oh my God, it's a twist, you would not believe what happened. Oh, you have to see this movie. Who wants to know what the movie was? You have a little more posture because you're having some excitement about it, you have more belief in it, because if you have a strong belief in the product, if you have a strong belief in what it is you're recommending, that comes across. You know, they talk about dogs can smell fear. Well, people can smell lack of confidence. If you don't believe that you can make the point, guess what? You can't. If you believe you're talking about the right product to the right person, you believe that firmly, they'll believe it from you. So we can't all go out and buy a website and try it out. It's not like OPC. You can't try OPC and have a personal response to it, or have a family member have a personal response to it. It shows you the results. So we're going to talk about what that belief can be built from by showing you some examples here. These are some websites. These are some before and afters. This is Schermerhorn Seafood. Okay, they did have a website. It had their address on it. It told some information. It's not very engaging. It's not something that I'm excited to see. I don't desperately want to check out this place. Take a look at what Web Center did for it. That's a little bit better. It's a little more engaging. It's something that gives you some, you know, your mouth starts to water, you want to go there and have that lobster. You know, it's something that is going to make people want to check out this place. There's another one, Diamond Gold Connection. This one, apparently this was just a scanned newspaper ad online. So it was, you know, it was cut off, it didn't fit on the page. I love the quote here. During our first year online with our old website, we did no sales, and our design was so horrible it was probably negatively affecting our business. So we want to see what they did for them.
Yeah.
Here's the new site. Not only did we have a more beautiful website that accurately represents the quality of our business, but since it is coupled with several marketing tools, we have cleared six figures in online sales during our first year of selling online. Extra twist, this is not a shop partner. So, you know, even better. Dave's Pet City. This was a site that, you know, they had a website that had some content. Nice little, is that a frog? I'm not even sure what that is. They had a very strong social media presence. They were very good on Facebook. But the problem with that is that didn't turn into sales. So they got a new site that was something they could drive people to. It's more engaging, and it's something they can use to drive people through to make sales, to close business, to make money. Okay, Blue Heron Bags. Okay, what we got here is a photo of a booth in a mall. And I can tell what hours they're there, and it's coming soon. Quick hint, Nisa's coming soon, and it's been that way for 3 years. It's probably not coming soon anymore. Here's the new site. This is the prototype. It's why it says good slogan. It doesn't have all the final finishing touches. But you can see they have a little roping. They have a lot of instructive style. It's much more engaging. You can actually see the products. All the pictures are better. So it's something that you want to have, you as a customer, you want to go in and see what's here. Edwin Seasonal Services. I don't even know what he does. Okay, this is a little better. Now I can tell you he's in landscaping. He's going to provide me a lawn looks like that. I have a lot more content, and I can see what's going on. And I can tell he's got summer and winter and fall services. So that is, in terms of being found online, being able to answer a question, obviously this is better. So you can see we're getting good results for our clients. When the small business owner is looking to get online, looking to get results, they've got to get solutions to all these challenges. They need all these things. We provide all this in a single solution. Instead of having to go to different providers for different components of their service, we provide it all in one shot. Here's an example of how we let them edit the website. This is a very powerful online editor. They sign into the office, they choose a web page to edit. And then if they've ever used a Microsoft Word or written an email, they simply click on the text, type the changes they want to make. If they want to change the formatting or highlighting, they can highlight a box of text. They can say, I want to change the color of this, maybe make it bold. And then I click save. And when they're done, they can hit publish and it's live on the web. Now, I worked with a supplier of green building supplies, you know, cork wall treatments and bamboo flooring. And she had a very good website that was built for her by an individual. But she had to pay to have changes made because she couldn't edit the website herself. That was reserved for the designer. He had that ability. So she wanted to change the hours her store was open. He didn't get around to it, and then he didn't get around to it, and then she got upset because people were calling on Saturday saying, why aren't you here? The website says you're open on Saturday. And he finally made the change, and then he sent her a bill for $200. Do you think that she liked the ability to do this? One point here, they can do this with any part of the website. It's not restricted to simply certain template areas that they're able to edit. They can edit any part of the website. Now, maybe working with images is more complicated. Maybe this part you want to take some notes on, because this is really carefully, watch these steps. The first thing you've got to do is you click on the image, and then you drag it onto the page. Do you all get that? Just one more time. Click on the image, and then you drag it on the page. It's just not that hard. Until these guys come up with the helmet that you wear on your head that like knows what you meant and just does it for you, until that point, this is as good as it's gonna get. This is just too easy. My technical background, I used to write CSS and you know, JavaScript code, and it was awful, and I hated it, and I had headaches, and my wife knows that I'd come home late at night complaining. That does not happen when you're working with this product. Now, we also do custom design. So, you know, we are not providing, you know, what you might see in other solutions where it's a pick from a list of pre-made templates. We have true custom design. So when we're developing a website for a customer, they get exactly what they want. They do not make compromises. You notice this is, you know, got a lot of color, it's got a lot of shading to it, and the menu color accents the color of the photo on the home page. You're not going to get that issue with the template. Another one here, totally different style, kind of fun, cow peeking around the corner. You know, this is fun to look at. It's engaging. What's this about? How do I learn about the new products? Here's a church site. Again, we have a calendar right here on the home page. We get support for them to get that out, and they're able to deliver that direct to their users, to their congregation. This one I love. In addition to the really fun name, at the top of the page here, you see this, the Home About Us blog? That's a menu. Are you going to find a pre-built template from which it's got a doggy and dog food themed menu? You're not going to find that. This is custom work. It's done for our customers to exactly match the look and feel they want. Again, cigar shop. Look at the notice, the skipping around the photo. This really is something that you're not going to find as a template. This was custom built for a customer. Exactly what can be captured to what they want to have their customer see. Again, a totally different style. This is a style that our customers want delivered to them, so their customers get the best impression of what they have. And here we have a garlic farm, I think it is. And you see a variety of products, big bold pictures up in there. And these, of course, this is one of the new responsive sites. So this is going to adjust to the size of the screen that's being viewed on. And again, another totally different style. Because the colors here, you see how they accent all the colors play together. It's a design that is both good to look at and informative, and at the whole time it's going to play well with Google and search engines. And again, you know, it just goes on and on. These are one-off custom designs that we're able to do at a very competitive price. Now, we also have e-commerce. E-commerce is the ability to sell products online. Many people would love to do that, but they think, oh my God, it's expensive, I can't afford it. That's not the case with the Web Center site, because we provide all of these services in our basic web solution. It's not an upgrade, it's included in the basic package. They're able to do all of these features. That means their customers get a shopper account, the ability to compare products, the ability to build a wish list. These are features you might expect to see on a Macy's.com, or a Target.com, or maybe even a Shop.com. And if you were a small business owner and went to somebody and said, I want these features on my website, you're not going to get it for under $10,000 or $20,000. Because talking about a lot of custom work, it's got to be customized for them. But we're able to provide it to our business owners at including our basic package because of the economies of scale. The ability to sell newsletters to customers, and lots of marketing tools. SEO is search engine optimization. That's sort of being found on Google. How many of you use Google? Everybody uses Google. It's a question. If you search for something and something is on the top of the page, that site has performed well in SEO. If you are meeting with a small business owner who is not showing up, they need SEO because they need their site optimized to appear. We have social media tools, which means being able to click into all these different, Facebook, Twitter, all that. Customer relationship management lets them track customers visiting their site, filling out forms, lets them incorporate them into email marketing, all those resources together. We handle it all in shops. So they're not having to buy this from this guy and this from this guy and some of each thing from a different version. It's all included. And we have unlimited resources. We have unlimited pages. Our small business owners can go in and add a page a day. I'm working with a chiropractor that has over 300 pages on his website. He is very verbose. He loves to write. And I say, have at it, because Google loves it. He's able to go in and make changes. anytime, not just him, but also a restaurant owner. It says, I want to change tomorrow's special tonight because I didn't sell much of the meatloaf and I'm going to get it on tomorrow's special menu. Well, they're able to do that. Unlimited traffic, that means they're not going to get hit with a bill or get cut off because they hit a limit. I don't know if you've ever seen this, you might see something, someone posts on social media or some other place, there's a hot link, hey, check out this website. You click the link, and instead of seeing what you thought you were going to see when you follow that link, what you see is a message that says, this website has exceeded its bandwidth. If you're the owner of this website, call this number. I've seen that more than once. Do you think that's a good thing for a small business owner to have happen to his website? It's actually a really bad thing, because right at the moment they get all the buzz, everyone's talking about them, that's the moment to get cut off. Unlimited email addresses, unlimited upgrades, I'll talk about that in a moment. But the biggest value here is unlimited support. They're able to call up our support department 24/7 and get additional help with any changes they want to make to the website. So if that restaurant owner needs help changing the specials on the menu, they're able to do that at 2:00 in the morning. Someone at Web Centers will answer the phone and help them with that. Now, here's some of the upgrades that we've gotten that are included. These are not up-fee charges for our customers. We got responsive websites. These are websites that automatically adapt to the size of the computer. So whether they be on a desktop, a laptop, a tablet, or a mobile phone, these websites automatically adjust, and we gave them the ability to do that without additional fee. We gave them lots of new widgets. We have menus and the ability to plug in Facebook and Instagram, all the components. And the email marketing system, which is a big upgrade we got maybe 2 years ago, I'm guessing. If you have ever heard of Constant Contact, this is something a lot of small business owners pay a monthly fee based on the size of their list. So the more names they have, the more they have to pay. They pay a monthly fee just to have this service to blast out messages to their customers. We have it included. And not only is it included, but it is beautiful. It has the ability to make a very attractive looking message that looks like their website so people don't get confused about the branding. And it tracks who opened the message and who put the link in it, and so they can see who their active customers are. Now we have the award-winning customer care. These are the guys that are there to answer the phone and support the customers. But lots of people offer, tech support or they might say they call it unlimited support, but it's unlimited support at correcting your billing information or resetting your password. But if you call GoDaddy and say, I can't figure out why this font is the wrong size, they're not going to help you with that because that's not what you're paying for. We have guys who will help our customers in correcting the layout and every little detail of their website. And we do not rush them off the phone. A couple years back, my wife had a problem with her cell phone. She had to call Verizon for a support issue. And they said, well, you have to do this upgrade. You have to connect these, you have to do this upgrade and then do these changes. And so she's on the phone for quite some time. And after a while, the representative says, I'm sorry we have to end the call because we've reached the limit. I can't be on the phone with you anymore. Is that a good customer experience? That won't happen with these guys. I don't call with easy questions. I call with hard questions. I already know the answers to the easy ones. I have been on the phone with them for hours. Or they have worked the problem and got back to me because they are dedicated to providing good support to our customers and solving the issue, not rushing them off the phone to minimize the cost of support. The facility has, a what I call an industrial level hosting. It is not, some amateur website in the basement kind of thing. There was a website designer in my area that had websites for a couple local businesses. And one evening, they all went down at the same time. And you know what happened? His basement flooded. That was not really the level of support, level of hosting you expect for a small business owner. They were putting too many eggs in one basket, too much dedication on something you didn't have back and forth. We have a facility that is monitored 24/7. It's got, high-end performance. It has what you expect for a decent professional website. Now, we have also the ability to plug into all these social media tools and the ability to market either of them. So if you have a business owner who says, gee, I'd like to be on Facebook or Twitter, but I don't know how to do it, or I don't have the time, that's okay, we can do that. We have that service now. We also have the ability to support our customers in multiple languages. Now, that means that if you encounter somebody who is more comfortable in another language, whether it be, you know, English, Spanish, or traditional, or simplified Chinese, that's for the content, or if the customer themselves is more comfortable speaking in Mandarin, Cantonese, or Spanish, we can do the sales demo in those languages, we can support the content in those languages, they have full support in any of those languages, you don't have to know those languages, you just have to connect them to our support department to do that. Now, what does that give you? That means that you can sell globally. That means that any of these countries, if you know somebody or have a contact who knows somebody or know somebody who knows somebody who knows somebody who needs a website, you're the guy. You're the gal. You can get them online by connecting with web centers, providing a solution. You don't need to have a language support. And what's great is if you're thinking about building one of these countries, you can use a website sale to finance the travel and lodging expenses to get there. Now, you know, a lot of people want to know, well, how do we compare to other services out there? Many of you probably heard of GoDaddy.
Yeah.
Where did you first hear about GoDaddy? Was maybe a Super Bowl ad? So that was a PSA ad, one of those free ads they did as a public service, right? No, that was the $3 million for 30 seconds ad. How do you think they pay for that if they're selling websites so cheap?
Customers' money.
The answer is they don't sell websites so cheap because they upcharge for everything. So while you might get the basic limited solution for cheap, everything you want to add to that is going to be more money, more money, more money. Like the example of the business owner who got charged for changes. It's a common thing you're going to find. You're going to get charged more for this and that. Traditional development is a common solution. There are many small shops who might have one guy or three or four guys in one shop building websites. They won't even talk to a business owner about a website for often less than $10,000 because they need to keep their lights on and pay their guys. Are there any traditional developers here in the room? A couple of hands. $10,000 for a website, is that a crazy number? He's shaking his head, yes. He's agreeing with me that that's what they're looking for. And there are other systems out there. Often people will get a free website that comes with some other service, like a print advertising or a Yellow Pages ad. And what's real crime about that is that while they get anything out of a website, what they really got is snooker because they often get locked into long-term contracts and have a website that is not optimized for them, it's optimized for somebody else. So you might go to the plumber's website, what he thinks is website, and there's his name and address at the top of the page, and right below it is an advertisement for the other services because they're the ones that pay the extra fee for the advertising. You like going to the dry cleaner, and before you can get into the door, there's a guy with a sandwich board trying to tell you about the dry cleaner down the street. Do you think it's a good business model? It's a terrible model. And so, I mean, these are scenarios where the business owners really get taken advantage of because of what's happening. But point to keep in mind here is that we have all these services included in one package, provided all together, all the resources. You don't need to know about it because we have guys that do it. You connect your customer with web centers, and they solve these issues for you. So the small business owner is trying to make that choice. The traditional company is going to be very cost prohibitive. Print company is going to be really optimizing for somebody else. Discount providers like GoDaddy, they're going to upcharge for this and that, every little feature. And do it yourself, that's the worst crime. Because while you might think you can build a website cheap, you are missing the hidden cost of time. Because consider the guy who's up late at night with the HTML, CSS manual trying to figure out how to address fonts and control layout. And if you really value your time and anything above, you know, minimum wage, you could easily see these websites costing someone $100,000 to build a website. It doesn't even look that good unless it's for e-commerce. And so what we provide is all those features together at a price that's very affordable and very competitive and provides so much more. And so we have all the ability to push out not only the beautiful designs you saw, the ability to both put content and posts and even marketing into social media. And we also have the ability to market to search engines. So if they want to have Google Ads bringing more customers, or Facebook Ads bringing more customers, they can do that too. Because it's all connected. It's a whole solution. This is not something we're trying to just pigeonhole one type of person into a box. We provide whatever they need to get it completed. So we have the great designs, the responsive. The premium responsive actually is a great entry level. If somebody has a financial challenge, they can go with a premium design, which lets them choose from a template, but it doesn't force them to stick with that template because everything's editable. And so they might like some parts of it, but change other parts. They can do it with support of tech support. So they're not locked in, they're able to get what they want. Social media, they're able to push their message out. Online reputation management, this is great. If they have some negative reviews or don't like what people find when they Google for them, you can fix that. You can put out more positive content, essentially delete negative reviews and control what does show up when someone does those searches. And then the ability to do Facebook advertising. And then, everybody wants to show up top of the page in Google. Well, no one who's reputable should guarantee that, but we do the proper steps, the legitimate steps, to get somebody showing up properly in the search engines, not just once, not just for a week, but long term, because we want to make sure that their business is running ongoing. And we finally have a managed membership option, which is a great option for someone who does not have the time to manage the website themselves. There's an upgraded monthly charge, but this means they can say, I want these changes made to my website. They send that to web centers, and it's done for them. Case closed. Completely solved. Now, I want to talk for a moment about what is success. You might say, well, success is I sold so many websites, or I closed so many deals, whatever it is that targeted your success. The problem is, we don't control whether or not somebody buys a website. We do control what we do. So we can control whether or not I talk to somebody. We can control, do we ask questions to get the conversation going? We can control, do we book appointments and work people into the system to have them talk to Brian Stice and to the product specialists? And so those are the steps. You repeat those steps, you will be a success, because I guarantee you, if you're doing these things and doing them again and again and again, you're going to close sales, you're going to make money, you're going to get that ongoing BV, and you're going to get your business growing. And so that's the target. That's what you want.